Mic check. Okay, I almost turned into a Reggie Rockstone, but Charlie, welcome to BTM Africa. I've got my brother here, Lekzy, Decomic.
Yeah, too cute to be mute.
Today?
Too cute to be mute, fresher than your ex, your current, and your next.
And also for
you? Yes, it's a boy. Who's all your and I was open your mouth.
Who baby be there for what's around?
Yeah, my name is Zainye.
Can it be? Too
okay,
cute to be
mute, louder than the future, father than the youth, fresher than your ex, your current, and your next.
That could be very insulting, pal. So, fresher than my ex.
Your current and your next.
Abante.
Yeah.
But you're right. Nana, intervene here. Alright, so Lekzy Decomic joins me today on BTM Africa. It's been an amazing year for him. I mean, from all the shows he's done, performing to some huge and highly influential people of society. He's traveled to Nigeria, played in Togo as well, done several shows in Ghana, hosted his own show as well. It's been an amazing year for you.
Yeah.
Lekzy, how many years have you been in the industry so far? Say, yeah, welcome.
I'll say 6 years.
6 years?
Yeah.
And for you to be able to hold your own show, put your own show together,
yeah,
how does that make you feel?
I would just say I thank God. It's not something that I joined comedy just to make a friend lose his job. He was pushing me to do comedy. Wherever he is, Jem, big shout outs.
He joined comedy just to make a friend lose his job.
He just hated the fact that people keep telling me, saying that GH comedians are not funny, GH comedians. Mm. But he has a friend who is way funnier than what people say. So he was then a radio presenter at Focus FM. And the guy is starting.
Go do that intro again. Yeah.
Better
than the
few,
better than the
few. Oh, Charlie. But I'm saying I didn't mean cutting
film. Oh.
My posting is
a. I'm a brand.
This is where you're one of the people out.
Yeah.
On Power Sax.
Yeah, on Power Sax. Yeah, and then a crash. Shut me, shut a while in.
Anyway, so you join comedy just to make sure somebody loses their job?
Yeah, just to prove a point.
On that losing note.
You see, they are just putting together a comedy show right now. They are putting together a comedy show altogether now. That was Foster Romano's anyway.
So, as I was saying, he's a radio presenter. He was then a radio presenter at Focus FM. Mm. So he's
on campus.
On campus. So he said, if I try comedy and it doesn't work, he will stop doing radio. Whoa. Which they had to bring his programs manager in as a witness.
Mm.
So my first time doing comedy, first 2 minutes, I had a standing ovation.
Whoa.
And I called him and I said, this is the situation. But for that moment, I felt like this is the space I belong.
Mm.
So when I joined comedy, I told myself that in the next 5 years, God should give me the chance to host my show at a very big auditorium. I don't know which auditorium. So last year was when National Theatre contacted me and they said they've seen my my show running like in the cinema halls.
Mm.
And I'm doing quite a good job. So
yeah,
they want me to partner with them for their theatre festival, which we did last year. My show recorded the second highest attendance event.
Wow.
on their theater festival. So this year they brought us on in line with their theater festival again, and it was mad, crazy lineup, everything. And people could see that it's an improvement on what we did last year. So I would say I would give thanks to God and for how far he's brought us.
You know, you are progressing. As you progress, obviously it comes with a lot of challenges as well. You said you're okay, and now you're playing the National Theater. You are traveling. I mean, if we perform it to our own crowd, you find some kind of solace in the fact that, oh, I'm in crowd.
Yeah.
But this year, you traveled as well, meeting a different audience altogether.
Yeah.
What was the mindset with you going into those territories? Because Togo, for instance, most of them speak French. It's a Francophone country.
Okay, with the Togo, big shout outs to my boss, Abeko Santana.
Mm.
He has this
travel
and tour, so like he actually conveyed people from Ghana. So I was just an icing on the cake. So I just went to entertain
the Ghanaians there,
with a few Togolese mixed in there.
Yeah.
But with the Nigeria, when I had a call from Macapella that he wants to put me on for a show, I was like, oh God, what am I going to do?
Were you prepared for that?
I had prepared to travel, maybe any of these days if I get a chance to travel out, I have a routine for.
Yeah,
but I didn't see it coming. Yeah, I was just there, I think 2 weeks to his show. He just said to me, I'm like, bro, I are you in for this? I said, I'm all in for it. He said, okay, fine, I'm putting you on the bill. Then we arranged and I went there. There was a little frustration came in at some point, but still I sailed through. They gave me like 15 minutes later, they had to beat it down to 10 minutes. When I got on stage, now they reduced the time to 7 minutes. The timer,
whoa,
there.
Yeah.
So I had to just squeeze in and drop the punchline in there. They just and walk off. But after the show, he was really happy about it. Even tweeted and sent a word or two about my performance on Instagram. So I would say, yeah, this year we've made progress, which we are hoping that next year we could like expand to other parts of the world, not just Africa.
Do you think the performances yourself and other comedians in Ghana are putting together is a vindication of what people have been saying, say Ghanaian comedians, or should I say it actually vindicates you people that you guys are funny, but the people were not giving you the opportunity and all that? Because we had platforms here in Ghana, and the amount for Barber performing and all that. I'm not condemning it, even though we have our own.
We also
want to go there, exactly. But then, do you think, sir? Yeah, you guys more yet now, no? It's enough to prove that lesson. We can also stand toe to toe with anybody, anyway.
Even before I joined comedy, DKB, Foster, like over the years, until we joined, like Obi, myself, and some few other guys who came, Chemical, like we came to like put more force in it. It's been there. Just that people didn't want to pay attention. But I think that thing too, everything has to be the positive and the negative. When people decided that they don't believe in us, they think we are not good enough. I think that provoked something in us to prove them that no, we can still do it.
Yeah.
But they didn't put us in our comfort zone for us to feel like we are all there. Now we were so hungry to make Ghanaians know that
you
we
can have deliver.
A yes. Yeah. So I think whichever way, I would say it helped us. Yeah, the negatives came, we had some bad feedback. And it pulled us back for quite a while, but I think God in his own plan now is making things work for us. So
now comedians in Ghana are able to put together their own shows.
Yeah.
I think you did that last year,
this year too. My show is a monthly comedy show which I do at the Snuff Cinemas, and every September I do a big one at the National Theatre. That's what the one I do with their theatre festival.
But I mean, you have returned December, you have something coming up,
December. I'm doing the all-white Christmas comedy show at the same venue, Snuff Cinemas. So when you're coming, just get your white. I don't care about your teeth, the color, just wear something white.
You know, this guy Upanka said something that had to feel your teeth because my favorite color be
yellow.
So you don't care about
it. I don't care whether it's a side effect or jaundice, you just just show up, just wear your white, come, let's laugh. We just want to change the whole vibe with comedy, not just go come sit down and the whole add a touch of class to it.
And when is it happening?
On the 21st of December.
Okay.
So it's happening at the Snuff Cinemas, and the rate is 30 Ghana cedis. Double is 50.
Okay.
And VIP is 50. So if you are out there and you're watching me, you can just grab your ticket and
come through Snuff Cinemas.
You get some of the tickets at the gate, so just don't bother yourself. Opposite to my station, the new AMA building, that's where Snuff Cinemas is. Just walk in and grab yourself a ticket.
I know comedy, I mean, and even the comedians, you are not too large a community in Ghana, but then we do understand there are hitches. I mean, even among the comedians, issues, it happens everywhere. But has that affected you anyway? I mean, since you joined, you met some people who were in there. Have you had that feedback of, I mean, somebody feels threatened and all that? Does it happen?
I don't know if this, I need to say this. I entered comedy without a plan. Later got a focus. I had a focus that, okay, I want to do this for myself. Maybe somebody might be hating on me or doesn't like what I do, but that's not what my attention is on, which I don't think anybody out there hates me, because it's all for the progress of GH comedy. But where my focus and where I am pushing towards and where I see myself in the future, I don't pay attention to
some of these things.
That it's like a distraction of to course. Me. So I don't pay attention. Whether you are somewhere trying to do one or two just to make things not work, that's none of my business. It will just make me lose focus. I don't pay attention to that.
That's great. I mean, like you said, it's kind of a distraction to everybody. It doesn't
because
make
if OB does it and it goes well, it's a credit to
the Ghanaian
comedy. I do it. It adds up to the success of GH comedy. First Tattoo does it. It adds up to the success of GH comedy. So I don't know why maybe somebody, which I think nobody does that, but if anybody is also doing that, I think it's not even needed.
What would you say is one of the challenges that you face as comedians in Ghana on the broader level? Like you are putting your show together, for instance. Obviously, one thing that I know cuts across is sponsorship. Do you also have that problem?
We've been struggling with sponsorship for quite a long time. I know the corporate bodies, they believe in numbers.
Yeah.
They don't just invest in anything.
They want something
that will give them the mileage and also expand their brand and this thing. So, but this year, God being so good, Casa Precom came to support my show with their new flavored water, Smart Choice.
Okay.
And Savannah to cider, premium cider came. That's the first of its kind
for you.
And Holland Life, an insurance company.
Okay.
And they also came on board. And there was one other company I keep forgetting. But whichever way, and when you check my poster, you still see them
see,
all.
See, okay.
So they came on board. We are making it's not as huge as maybe they would have invested in music.
Maybe music.
But for the fact that if somebody's giving half a loaf is better than none, for the fact that they see something in us, they want to even give us 5 CD, 10 CD or whatever. I think with time
it's a kickstart, like,
we will get there. So with sponsorship, it's still a struggle. But I know with time, like, they'll get to understand us and come in. But that notwithstanding, I think it's about time now that people are like beginning to love GH comedians. They shouldn't wait till, because now when you mention concert party, people tag Kiso
along.
So now that like comedy is like a fallow ground
now.
People have not really paid attention
to it.
It would be good if any big company out there would come in and invest.
Starts
in
now.
Yes, so that people, we can just tag along with the GH comedy vibe. Because when you go to Nigeria, you can't mention Nigerian comedy without Globe.
Yeah,
they sponsor, I think, almost all their comedy shows. And so that's what is driving the brand Glow, and Glow is driving the brand
comedy.
Nigerian comedy. So I think I'll urge all of them to also come on board.
So corporate Ghana, your help is really needed, because I mean, we can't do it all alone, especially when it has to do with showbiz, where we have the numbers. And now the comedians are proving things wrong. I mean, they are putting together their own shows, they are coming together to put shows together, and they are selling numbers, they are selling arena. So we're looking forward to some of these. Of course, as you come in to sponsor the show as well.
Yeah, we need to, because he's one of the few who are like, he's held us down when nobody believed in us. So
I
from
try.
Day one, yeah.
I try.
And I'll take this opportunity to also talk to some of these bloggers that I sometimes, when I see some of the stories they pick, maybe somebody will comment and that Jaru or somebody's posted, they will pick somebody comment and Basketman will post maybe Obi's picture that he's on his show, or Lekzy on a Capella show. They follow all these big guys in it, and nobody will talk about it. But if I had gone to Nigeria and maybe bottles had been thrown at me, I don't know who, they will tell you, get a publicist. But the bad news, I don't pay any publicist. How you guys manage to get the news? I have no idea.
Me being a blogger, let me come in here.
Yeah.
I'll share something with you. One of the things is that, you know, I try as much as possible to stay away from those kind of stories. I feel it doesn't augur too well for me, so I stay away from them. But then for those who normally do that, the thing is that it is because that's what fetches them the traffic. You see, I keep complaining and say that, okay, Ghanaians will cry and say, hey, people like publishing bad news, you like publishing negative news. But then at the end of the day, these same Ghanaians are the people who are reading those news.
But
imagine nobody was going in for that content. The bloggers will be held back. They wouldn't want to do that.
I'm coming. But you know that the media sometimes can direct the
of course attention of the attention.
Yes, because there are some songs that don't even, let me say, make sense.
Yeah.
But the media can still drum it into the heads of people and it becomes, the media has created superstars out of nobody. Like people who have, so I feel, yes, once we just, let's keep the balance. The energy they pump into pushing our negative stuff, I think they should use same energy to push us. When I felt like after OB show like this, feeling that it is all over social media. Somebody should talk about it. After Laughline National Theatre, somebody should, yes, my blogger will write about it and all that. But I don't pay for the negative news. So at least once in a while.
But then that's, easy. That's human nature.
When Sarkodie won the BET, you can't tell me that if you publish a story like that, nobody will read.
Of course.
They will still read.
Just like corporate companies will want to come in because of mileage and all that. Some of these blogs also look at that. Which, you know why people are writing about Sarkodie, Shatawale, Stoneboy all the time? It's because these people have numbers, people who want to read. So anything about them will bring them the traffic, which they are also looking at converting into money. So they want to do it. But then when there's a situation where they find they are posting, me for instance, I've just had to stand my ground not to do some of these negative content, because doing all the positive doesn't really pay. Do you get it? You put all the good content together and people wouldn't read. Somebody once told me that Chalisa would their whole story Ninyanash headline, because I go straight to the point. I don't want to be sensational and say this person does that. Then exactly. I just want it to be straight to the point. But people don't prefer that. So blogs have also found ways of trying to get the traffic, because I mean, you don't just write for yourself. You want the numbers. But I do understand when you say there should be a balance.
Yes, I feel they are forcing us all to maybe be all controversial, do things we don't want to do, because then the positive will definitely not get
it
out.
It takes a
traffic,
long time
so,
I
feel.
But don't lose hope. I mean,
no,
good people out there.
Summer. The likes of Odate, GH, Kobiche, yourself, Amiyao, Deborah, once in a while comes in for us. And Graphic Showbiz, once in a while, they come in for us. Big shout outs to Gifty inside Graphic Showbiz, holding us down. I think, but there is more to be done. There is more to be done.
I think there's the need for us to support each other and make sure that the right things get out there. Of course, that's a plea he is actually putting across to everybody who is supposed to be supporting GH Comedy. So, Lekzy, I want to thank you very much for spending time with me.
I'm really honored.
And we pray that GH Comedy, of course, rises, because when it rises, it puts all of us up there. It puts money in your pocket. That's when you're also able to pay a blogger cash, cash, cash. So, Charlie, you also do this
after this interview like this. If some brown envelope be there and with your outfit like this, Charlie.
I can make the time go be
Charlie, you guys should just go and watch. Just watch this video, share, make it trend, so that people will believe that it's not necessarily about the negative things that you guys are interested in.
Of course.
Sometimes you buy into the positives too. Thanks.
All right, but somebody wants to check you out on social media and all that. How do they do that?
Okay, on Facebook is Lekzy the Comic. Lekzy the Comic, L-E-K-Z-Y. The Comic is D-E-C-O-M-I-C. Autocorrect might give you demonic. Still change it back to the Comic. On Instagram is Lekzy_the_comic, same spelling, and Instagram Lekzy_the_comic. Follow me and I'll follow back, like my page, and I'll still feed you with good content. And my YouTube channel too is Lekzy_the_comic, same spelling.
Guys, check him out on all the social media pages is announced, and
and my mobile money number too is
you don't want to mention that number. Maybe another girls now.
Slide it to my DM, you have it.
DMs are very dangerous, my people. Anyway, my name is NYDJ. It's been good coming your way with BTM Africa. Catch you some other time. Remember to leave your comments, share this video like you said, and let's support Ghanaian comedy. Thank you very much for watching, and thanks to Nana Tutu, who might be fired very soon because you asked him to position the camera this way and he's watching his phone and the camera is filming our empty stage and all that. We'll talk about that later.
I hope my height, he captured it, because
he actually had to draw the tripod down for this one.
That's the presidential height. Let's cut.
Thank you very much for watching. Catch you some other time.